请我们看希伯来书第八章。
Let's read Hebrew chapter 8.
我们从第十节念起。
We'll start from verse 10.
我先用中文念一遍，然后请我的弟兄用英文念一遍。
I will read it in Chinese once, and then in English and again.
主又说：“那些日子以后，我与以色列家所立的约乃是这样：我要将我的律法放在他们里面，写在他们心上；我要做他们的神。” 他们要做我的子民，他们不用个人教导自己的邻舍和自己的弟兄说：“你该认识主。”因为他们从最小的到至大的都必认识我。我要宽恕他们的不义，不再纪念他们的罪愆。
For this is a covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my laws in their mind and write them on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. None of them shall teach his neighbor, and none of his brother, saying, Know the Lord, for all shall know me, from the least of them to the greatest of them, for I will be merciful to the unrighteousness, and their sins and their lawlessness I will remember no more.
请我们再看以弗所第一章。So
we also read Ephesians chapter 1.
我们从十五节念起。Verse
15.
因此，我既听见你们信从主耶稣，亲爱众圣徒，就为你们不住地感谢神。 祷告的时候，常提到你们，求我们主耶稣基督的神，荣耀的父，将那使人智慧和启示的灵赏给你们，使你们真知道他，并且照明你们心中的眼睛，使你们知道他的恩召有何等指望，他在圣徒中得的基业有何等丰盛的荣耀。
Therefore, I also, after I heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love for all the saints, do not cease to give thanks for you, making mention of you in my prayers, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give to you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, in the eyes of your understanding, being enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling, what are the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power toward us who believe, according to the working of his mighty power.
最后请我们看约翰一书。Lastly,
shall we read 1 John?
约翰一书第一章第五节。First
John chapter 1, verse 5.
神就是光，在他毫无黑暗。这是我们从主所听见，有报给你们的信息。This
is the message which we have heard from him and declare to you that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all.
第七节。Verse
7.
我们若在光明中行，如同神在光明中，就彼此相交。 他儿子耶稣的血也洗净我们一切的罪。But
if we walk in the light, as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanses us from all sin.
第二章,
Chapter 2,
27-28节,
Verses 27 and 28.
你们从主所受的恩膏 常存在你们心里, 并不用人, 教导你们，自有主的恩膏在凡事上教训你们，这恩膏是真的，不是假的。你们要按着恩膏的教训住在主里面。小子们呢，你们要住在主里面，这样他若显现，我们就可以坦然无惧，在他来的时候，在他面前也不至于惭愧。
But the anointing which you have received from him abides in you, and you do not need that anyone teach you, but as the same anointing teaches you concerning all things, and is true, and is not a lie, and just as it has taught you, you will abide in him. And now, little children, abide in him, that when he appears, we may have confidence and not be ashamed before him at his coming.
请我们有一点祷告。
Shall we have a word of prayer as well?
主，当我们聚集在你面前的时候，
Lord, as we gather here before you,
我们满心感谢赞美你。
Our heart is filled with praise and thanksgiving.
因为在千万人中，你竟然拣选了我们。
Because among the thousands of people, you have chosen us.
你竟然怜悯我们，叫我们能平安聚集在你的面前。
And you have chosen us so that we can gather before you in peace.
主，今天早晨你有什么话要对我们说，请说。
Lord, this morning, if you have any words to speak to us, please speak.
我们都是你的仆人，我们敞开我们的心向着你。
We are all your servants, and let us open our hearts towards you.
求你对我们说话。
Please speak to us.
求你光照我们。
Please enlighten us.
求你带领我们进入你自己。
Please allow us to enter and abide in yourself.
好叫你自己荣耀的旨意能完成在我们这些卑贱人的身上。
That your glorious will can be accomplished in these earthly vessels.
我们要把尊贵荣耀、国度、权柄全归给你。
And we give you all the honor, glory, power, and the kingdom.
奉主耶稣基督的名。
In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for giving us another opportunity.可以一同聚集在他的面前。
We thank the Lord that He has given us another opportunity to gather before Him.
我盼望弟兄姊妹还能记得。
I hope that brothers and sisters can still remember.
我们这一次一同聚集，并不是听道。
When we gather here this time, we are not trying to hear some doctrines.
我们这一次那是大家一同进到健身房里面来操练。
And we will want to enter into
gymnasium
and to exercise.
如果我们到学校里面去听讲的话，
If we enter to a school to listen,
我们可以很消极的在那里听。
We can listen to it very passively.
如果我们到健身房里去操练的话，
but we go into a gymnasium to exercise.
那我们每一个人必须要聚精会神，把自己交在主的手里。
We need to pay attention and commit ourselves in the hands of the Lord.
圣经告诉我们说，操练身体一处还少。
The Bible tells us that exercising our physical body.Profits a little.
这并不是说神轻看我们操练身体。
It's not that God despises our exercising of our physical body.
神创造我们这一个又奇妙又可畏的身体。
When God created this amazing body,
他要我们在身体上面能荣耀他。
He wants us to glorify Him in our body.
所以我们应当操练我们的身体。
Therefore, we need to exercise our body.
叫我们有健康的身体， 能服侍他。
So that we have a healthy body to serve him.
但是圣经告诉我们还有一种的操练。
But the Bible also tells us that there is another exercise.
那与身体的操练比较的话，那操练身体益处还少。
If you compare that with exercising our physical body, then exercising our body is profits only a little.
所以在提摩太前书第四章第八节说。
Therefore, 1 Timothy 4:8 tells us.
操练金钱凡事都有益处。
Exercising godliness, it profits everything.
它有生命的应许。
It has the promise of life.
这个生命乃是神圣的生命。
This life is a holy life.
不光是一个肉身的生命。
It's not just physical life.
肉身的生命不过是暂时的。
Physical life is only temporal.
但是神圣的生命是永远的。
But this holy life is eternal.
所以神应许说，
That's why God promised.
如果我们操练金钱的话，
If we exercise godliness,
他应许我们有神圣的生命的应许。
He has given us the if we exercise godliness, He has given us the promise of this holy life.
不但在今生，也在来世。
Not only this life, but also the life to come.
因为操练金钱，通俗一点点来说，就是操练向神。
So exercising godliness, in other words, it is exercising being like God.
那个意思就是说，我们要有像神那样的性格。
In other words, we need to have characters of God.
因为神的旨意是要我们磨成他儿子的形象。
Because it's the will of God that we should be we should be conformed to the image of His Son.
操练金钱乃是进入神旨意的那个门。
So exercising godliness is the door to enter into the will of God.
保罗说我们努力都是为了这一个。
Paul reminds us that the reason we labor so hard is for this.
所以亲爱的弟兄姊妹。
So dear brothers and sisters.
我不知道在座的弟兄姊妹是否在那里劳苦努力在操练金钱。
So I do not know if you are laboring hard to exercise this godliness.
操练金钱乃是操练神所赐给我们的那个灵。
Exercising godliness is to exercise the spirit that God has given us.
因为神是灵。
Because God is spirit.
人必须要用灵和诚来敬拜他。
We need to worship Him in spirit and in truth.
但是灵不是物质的东西。
But spirit is not material thing.
我们看不见他。
We cannot see Him.
但是并不因着看不见就不是事实。
It's not because we cannot see Him and therefore He doesn't exist.
实际上来说，看不见的比看得见的更其实。
What you cannot see is more real than what you can see.
圣经说看得见的是暂时的。
The Bible said what you can see is temporal.
看不见的是永远的。
What you cannot see is eternal.
所以神所赐给我们那个灵虽然看不见确实非常实在的。
The spirit that God has given us, even though we cannot see it, but it's real.
我们基督徒属灵的生活完全在这个灵里面。
The spiritual life of a Christian is all in this spirit.
如果我们不操练我们的灵，我们没有办法进入基督徒属灵的生活。
If we do not exercise the spirit, we cannot enter into this spiritual life of a Christian.
我们已经说过这个灵虽然不能见，
We have already said, even though we cannot see the Spirit,
但是借助它的功用，我们知道它的存在。
But according to its function, we can We can know that it exists.
所以所谓的操练灵，就是操练灵里面的那个功用。
So, when we say exercising the spirit, what we are saying is exercising the functions of the spirit.
圣灵住在我们的心灵的里面。
The Holy Spirit dwells in our spirit.
他要教导我们怎样来操练我们的灵。
He will teach us how to exercise our spirit.
他要教导我们怎样操练我们灵里面的那个良心。
He will teach us how to exercise the conscience of our spirit.
我们常常说良心是神的声音。
We always say that the conscience is the voice of God.
神对我们说话。
God speaks to us.
他就是来摸我们的良心。
He is trying to touch our conscience.
叫我们在良心里面能知道是或者非。
So that our conscience can tell us whether it's right or it's wrong.
让我们在良心里面用一个无愧的良心活在神面前也活在人面前。
We need to have a pure conscience to live before God and before man.
所以良心啊与公义有实际的关系。
Therefore, conscience and the righteousness has a direct relationship.
感谢赞美主。
We praise and thank God.
他用他的宝血洗净我们的罪。
He has washed our sins with his blood.
他叫我们在基督里面称义。
So that we will be justified in Jesus Christ.
这是我们的地位。
This is our position.
但是我们既然有了这个地位。
Now that we have this position.
我们在日常的生活中我们要行义。
So that in our daily life, we will have to walk righteously.
我们怎么能行义呢?
How can we walk righteously?
我们怎么是知道什么是神所称义的,什么是神所定罪的呢?
How can we tell what is right in the eyes of God and what is wrong?
这是就是圣灵来摸我们的良心。
And this is how the Holy Spirit touch our conscience.
所以我们需要来操练。
Therefore, we need to exercise.
当圣灵摸我们良心的时候，
When the Holy Spirit touches our conscience,
我们应当有反应。
We need to have a response.
我们不应当抹杀良心的声音。
We cannot just suppress the feeling of the conscience.
我们要照着良心的指示来遵行神的旨意。
We need to obey the will of God according to the feeling of the conscience.
这一个我们在上个礼拜已经交通过了。
And last week we shared on this already.
所以今天早晨我们预备操练第二个功用。
This morning we want to talk about exercising the second function.
在我们的灵里面还有一个功用。
In our spirit, there is another function.
这个功用叫做直觉。
And this function is called intuition.
直觉是什么东西呢?
What is intuition?
那你听见直觉这两个字。
When you hear the word intuition,
我想你就能领会到在这里有一种的知识乃是直接的。
You can tell that there is some knowledge here which is direct.
我们普通人讲的知识
When we talk about knowledge in human terms
都是头脑的知识
It is all knowledge of the head
感谢赞美主
We thank praise God
他给我们有五角五觉
He have given us the five senses
那借着我们的五觉我们就与世界来接触
Through these five senses, we can have contact with the world.
所以从我们生下来
So from the day that we are born,
我们就与这个世界有接触
We are in contact with this world.
我们生长的时候，我们就在那里收集各种各样的知识
So when we are growing up, we collect different kinds of knowledge.
从眼睛 从耳朵从各方面我们来收集各样的知识。
So from our eyes, from our ears, from our different senses, we collect different kind of knowledge.
我们的头脑啊实在是奇妙。
Our mind is very amazing.
虽然我们的头脑那么小小的。
Even though our head is so small,
但是我们能收集的那些的资料啊是没有限制的。
The amount of information or knowledge that we collect is unlimited.
今天是 computer age.
Today is a computer age.
而我们觉得这 computer 非常奇妙。
We feel that the computers are very amazing.
怎么这个小小的东西呀，能装那么多的 data 呢？
And this little thing can give you so much data.
但是我们的人，神给我们的头脑啊，那比任何的 computer 还奇妙啊。
The mind that God has given us is more amazing than any computer.
有人告诉我们说，如果你要照着我们的头脑所能吸收的来造一个 computer 的话
，If you want to build a computer according to the brain that we have,
那这个 computer 要 occupy a block.
This computer can occupy a whole block.
我们这个头脑小小的
，Our brain is so small.
你看多奇妙啊！
Isn't it amazing?
我们就能吸收从外面来的知识。
It can collect any information or data from outside.
我们能把它分析起来。
We can deduce it.
我们能理解它。
We will understand it.
我们能把它收藏起来，等候用处。
And we store them so that we can use them when the time comes.
这个知识啊，就叫我们知道怎样做人了。
All this knowledge allow us to determine how to be a person.
怎样过人的生活？
How we can live a life of a man?
如果一个人无知无识的话，那我们说这个做人都是冤枉的了。
So if a person who has no knowledge, then we think he's living in vain.
所以我们要上学呢。
So when we go to school,
上学做什么呢？
What do we do in school?
就吸收各种各样的知识吗？
So we collect different type of data and knowledge.
叫我们成为一个有知识的人
，so that we can be a knowledgeable person。
这与我们的生活有非常大的关系。
And it has a great relationship with to our life。
弟兄姊妹
，brothers and sisters，
我们怎么能过属灵的生活呢
？How do we live spiritual life？
属灵的生活不是凭着我们头脑的知识来活的。
Spiritual life is not according to the knowledge of this brain.
头脑的知识不过叫我们知道在地上怎样做人。
The knowledge of our brain only allows us to know how to be a person in this world.
我们既然有了属灵的生命
，Now that we have spiritual life，
我们要过属灵的生活。
We need to live spiritual life.
这个属灵的生活。那是要凭着里面的那一个知识来活的。
And this spiritual living is according to the inner, the direct knowledge in our spirit.
你知道今天在神的儿女中有个错误的思想。
You know there is a wrong a concept among brothers and sisters.
以为说，如果我们要过属灵的生活，我们需要。吸收一些神学的知识。
We always thought that if we want to live spiritually, we need a lot of theology.
你多吸收地上的知识，叫你在地上做人。
If you have more worldly knowledge, you can be a better worldly person.
你如果多吸收一点神学的知识，就叫你过属灵的生活。
And if you have more theology in you, then you can be a better spiritual person.
但是所谓神学的知识是怎么得来的呢？
But where does this theology come from?
那你要进神学院咯。
And then you have to go to the theology college.
你要多参加一点特别聚会咯。
And you have to go to a different seminary.
你要多去听听，多去看看，多去想想咯。
And you have to go see more, hear more, and think about it more.
弟兄姊妹
Francis,
但是这些的知识是从哪里来的
And where does this knowledge come from?
这些知识还是从外面来的
It's also coming from the outside
你用什么东西来吸收的呢
What, how do you receive them?
你还是用你头脑的知识来吸收的。
You still use your brain to absorb them.
叫你头脑很大。
That your brain will be growing.
但是叫你走树林的道路的脚就很小。
And the feet that you need to walk spiritually is very small.
因为这些还是外面的知识。
Because these are still external knowledge.
不是直接的知识。
This is not direct knowledge.
不是里面的知识。
It is not the inner knowledge.
不是从启示来的知识。
It is not a knowledge from inspiration.
不是生命的知识。
It is not a knowledge of life.
弟兄姊妹。
Dear brothers and sisters.
要过属灵的生活就需要有直觉的操练。
So if you want a spiritual living, you need intuition.
保罗写信给以弗所人。
And Paul wrote to the Ephesians.
我们读圣经的人都知道，以弗所书乃是保罗书信里面在真理方面是登最高的地位。
When we read the Bible, we realize that Ephesians is the highest of the doctrines.
他与哥林多人不能谈这些事情。
Paul cannot speak to the Corinthians about this type of things.
但是对以弗所的信徒，他能把那一个属天的奥秘与他们交通。
But to the Ephesians, Paul can share with them the mystery of heaven.
但是虽然如此。
Even though it's like this,
如果你读以弗所书的话，
but if you read the book of Ephesians,
他讲了没有几句啊，就跪下来祷告。
He didn't say too much, and then he had to start kneeling down.
那为什么？
Why is it so?
因为到他开始要分享的时候，他里面就有一个感觉。
When Paul was about to share, then there is a feeling inside of him.
这些东西不是外面可以教导的。
And these are not something that he can teach them from the outside.
这些东西也不是人的头脑就能领会的。
These are not something that man's brain can understand.
所以他就求我们的神。
Therefore, he prayed to our God.
主耶稣基督的父。
The Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
要把智慧和启示的灵赏给我们。
Give them the spirit of wisdom and truth.
叫我们真正的知道神。
So that we can truly know God.
这里的知道是 epignosis, 真正的知道神。
And this knowing is knowing, truly knowing.
并且照明我们心中的眼睛。
And to enlighten the eyes of our hearts.
这个心中的眼睛才是我们的心思。
The eyes of our hearts is our
mind.
心思 our mind.、
Yeah. 所以第一是在灵里面。
So the secret is in the spirit.
在灵里面有智慧，有启示。
In the spirit, there's wisdom and there's revelation.
然后在我们的心思里面能明白它。
And then our mind will understand it.
叫我们真知道神的恩召是何等的浩大。
And that we can understand the greatness of the calling of God.
神在他圣徒身上所得的基业是何等丰富的荣耀。
And the inheritance that God has obtained in the saints is so glorious.
神在新的人身上所实现的能力是何等的浩大。
And the greatness of the power that God has revealed to his people.
所以这些东西你就看见都是发源在智慧和启示的灵。
And all this you will discover that it starts from the spirit of wisdom and revelation.
智慧是什么？
What is wisdom?
智慧与知识不同。
Wisdom is different from knowledge.
知识是你懂得这些东西。
Knowledge means that you know of something.
智慧是你会应用你所懂得的。
Wisdom is knowing how to use what you have obtained.
神所给的知识都是可以应用的。
The knowledge that God has given you can be applied.
并且是从启示来的。
And this is all from Revelation.
亲爱的弟兄姊妹。
Dear brothers and sisters.
有一件事是神的儿女必须承认的。
And there's one thing that all the brothers and sisters must confess.
因为圣经也是这样教训。
The Bible also teaches that.
圣经说，说肉体的人不领会属灵的事情。
The Bible says, men of the flesh will not understand spiritual things.
他也不会领会。
They are unable to understand.
因为他认为这些是愚昧。
They thought that these are foolishness.
属灵的事，只有属灵的人才能领会的。
Only spiritual men can understand spiritual things.
所以当我们摸到属灵的事情的时候，
So when we are touching on spiritual things,
我们必须有一个态度。
We need to have an attitude.
这是远超过我甚多能及的。
It surpasses what I can understand.
弟兄姊妹，
Brothers and sisters,
我们要有这样的态度。
We need to have such an attitude.
我们才能明白属灵的事情。
And then we can understand spiritual things.
我常常说一句话。
I always say this.
我说所有的基督徒都是神学家。
I thought that all Christians are theologians.
为什么？
Why is it so?
因为当你在读圣经的时候，
When you're reading the Bible,
你在那里做什么？
What are you doing there?
你在那里解说吗？
You are trying to interpret it.
所以你都是神学家。
You are a theologian.
但是我们要看见属灵的事非从启示而来，都是虚假的。
Well, sister, you have to see that if it's not from revelation, all these things are vanity.
都不实在。
They are not real.
不能应用。
You cannot apply them.
神的话是活的，是应用的。
The words of God is living and it can be applied.
为什么我们读神的话？
Why are we reading the words of God?
而我们不能应用。
If we cannot apply them,
在我们身上不发生过作用。
And it will not have effect in our life.
表明我们与神的话之间有一个间隔。
And it reflects that there is a barrier between us and the words of God.
我们需要求神赐给我们智慧和启示的灵。
We need to pray to God and ask Him for the spirit of wisdom and revelation.
如果我们连这个态度都没有的话，
If we do not even have this attitude,
我们都是属灵的外行。
We are outsiders of the spirit.
感谢赞美主。
We praise and thank God.
今天我们信主的人是活在新约的里面。
Today we Christians living in the New Testament.
我们不是活在旧约的里面。
We are not living in the Old Testament.
今天有一件可惜的事。
Something that is unfortunate.
基督教越来越回到旧约里头去了。
Christianity is drifting closer and closer back to the Old Testament time.
你如果去观察的话，
If you examine it closely,
那是很清楚的。
It's very clear.
但是我们要知道，神已经把我们带到新约里面了。
But we need to know clearly that God has already brought us into the New Testament.
我们今天做基督徒的人，不是活在旧约里，是活在新约里面。
We Christians do not live in the Old Testament. We live in the New Testament.
感谢赞美主，旧约是从神来的。
We praise and thank God. The Old Testament is from God.
但是它是一个准备。
This is only a preparation.
新约才是他的目的。
The New Testament is his goal.
虽然神与以色列人要立的新约还在将来。
Even though the New Testament that God has with the Israelites is still in the future.
但是当主耶稣被钉之前，在晚餐的时候
，Before the Lord Jesus Christ was crucified during the Last Supper，
他拿起杯来 他说这是我用血所立的新约。
He took up the cup and he said, "This is the blood, the new covenant that I have set up."
你们都要喝纪念我。
You shall all partake of this to remember me.
换一句话说
，In other words,
在主里面，他把我们带到新约的里面去。
In Christ, he brought us into the New Testament.
在新约的里面有三件事。
In the New Testament, there are three things.
神做了三件事。
God has done three things.
第一件事。
Firstly,
他要把他的律法刻在我们的心里。
He will put his words into our hearts.
他要做我们的神，我们要做他的儿女，不行。
He will be our God, and we will be his people.
第二。
Secondly,
他们不用人来教导他们，你该认识神。
They do not need to be taught that they need to know God.
因为从他们最小的到最大的，都要在他们里面认识我。
From the youngest to the oldest, they will know me from the inside.
第三。
Thirdly.
我不再纪念，不再我赦免他们的罪，不再纪念他们的过犯。
I have forgiven their sins, and I will not remember their iniquities.
这是神在基督的宝血里与我们所立的约。
And this is the New Testament that God has with us in the blood of our Lord.
第二点是什么呢
？What is the second point?
你们不用人来教导你们，你该认识谁。
You do not need anyone to tell you, to teach you that you need to know God.
这是旧约。
That's the Old Testament.
旧约以色列人他怎么能认识神呢
？In the Old Testament, how do the Israelites know God?
需要人来教导他们。
They need others to teach them.
需要有祭司。有利未人来教导他们。
They need the priests and the Levites to teach them.
而这个认识这个字在原文里头是普通的认识。
This word knowing in the original text, it is the regular meaning of knowing.
新约说不用人来教导你。
In the New Testament, it says you do not need anyone to teach you.
那么弟兄姊妹今天你是活在新约里呢你是活在旧约里
So brother and sister Are you living in the New Testament Or are you living in the Old Testament
你是不是觉得说没有人教导我怎么知道呢
Are you feeling that if no one is teaching me How can I know
那人能教导你能教导到什么程度
What degree can man teach you
他只能在外面教导叫你头脑灵魂
He can only teach you on the outside that your mind will understand.
这个认识主是 know about God, 不是 know God.
This is only knowing about God, it's not knowing God.
真正的认识主是里面的。
The true knowing God is from the inside.
他说因为他们从最小的，记得从最小开始。
Remember, they start from the very young.
你一得救以后
，In other words, the day that you are saved,
就开始了。
You start from there.
一直到最大的
，To the greatest.
他们必须在他们里面真正的认识我。
They need to know God from the inside.
这个认识在原文里头乃是。里面的认识 conscious knowledge.
This knowing God in the original text is conscious knowledge.
那是实际 实用的 experimental knowledge.
This is experimental knowledge of God.
这是真正的认识。
This is true knowing of God.
弟兄姊妹，这是新约。
This is the New Testament.
我们是活在新约里的人。
We live in the New Testament.
为什么？我们今天在我们里面就能认识神。
Why Do we know God from the inside?
因为在神所给我们心灵的里面有一个直觉的作用。
Because in our spirit, there's a function in there. It's called intuition.
并且圣灵就住在我们灵里面来教导我们。
And the Holy Spirit dwells in our spirit and teaches us.
约翰一书第二章第二十七节。
First John chapter 2, verse 27.
他说你们有恩膏住在你们里面。
You have the anointing in you.
在原文里头这个恩膏啊乃是一个 gerund, 就是又是名词又是 动词。
This word anointing is a dual word. It's a noun. It's also a word.
为什么？
Why is it so?
因为表明它是在哪里作用的。
It reflects the fact that it is functioning.
我们知道这个恩膏啊，就是指着圣灵说的。
We know that this anointing refers to the Holy Spirit.
我们每一个信主的人都有圣灵住在我们里面。
Everyone that believes in Christ has the Holy Spirit abiding in us.
圣灵像一个恩膏一样。
So the Holy Spirit is like an anointment.
因为他在那里附魔作用，所以称他为 anointing。
Because of this anointing function, that's why it's called anointing。
好像今天，如果你什么地方不舒服，擦一点油啊，摸摸它，就觉得很舒适的意思。
Just say if you are not feeling well anywhere in your body, you anoint it with some medication, and you feel better.
所以圣灵在我们灵里呀、啊。就在那里像个膏油一样来涂抹我们。
So the Holy Spirit is like an anointment, anointing us.
那么他在那里这样的起作用啊，为什么原因呢？
What is the reason for this function?
他要在凡事上教导你们。
So it is, he is going to teach us in everything.
你里面已经有一个在凡事上教导你的教师啊，你还用得着外面的人来教导你吗
？So if you have a teacher inside of you already, do you still need a teacher on the outside to teach you？
那么这样把这些的教师通通丢到窗外去。
So we can cast away all these teachers then。
你们把我赶出去就完了。
You can just cast me out。
那为什么还有人在那里教导呢？
Then why do we still need teachers to teach us?
神兴起使徒先知教师牧师传福音要做什么呢
？So God raised up apostles, prophets, pastors and teachers. Why is it so?
记得
，remember this.
你的灵魂在神的眼中是最宝。
Your spirit and your soul is very precious in the eyes of God.
神既然拯救了你，
God has already saved you.
他不会把你放在任何的人的手里。
And he will not put you in the hand of any person.
他自己要来当心你。
So he himself will be responsible for you.
弟兄姊妹，
Brothers and sisters,
感谢主。
We praise God.
但是因为我们还幼稚。
But because we are still young and ignorant.
在属灵的事情上还不够敏锐。
In spiritual things, we are still not sharp enough.
所以有的时候我们的感觉不清楚。
So our feeling may not be clear enough.
甚至有的时候我们会领会错。
At times, we may be wrong as well.
所以神就预备外面认识他的来帮助我们。
Therefore, God used people who know him to help us.
他们能印证，他们也能改正。
And they can verify and correct us.
但是领导的是神自己。
But the leader is God himself.
所以亲爱的弟兄姊妹,
Dear brothers and sisters,
不要活在旧约的里面,
do not dwell in the Old Testament.
今天神的儿女都活在旧约的里面,
Today, God's children are always living in the Old Testament.
所以属灵的生量不长大,
and their spiritual stature do not grow.
容易错误,
easy to be misled.
引到异端里面去,
misled into heresies.
尤其在这末后的日子,
especially in this last age.
如果神的儿女能操练他的知觉,
if Christians can exercise their intuition,
能从神那里直接的领受,
to receive this directly from God,
弟兄姊妹,
brothers and sisters,
我们能脱离许许多多的异端邪道,
we can avoid a lot of heresies and wrong doctrines.
也叫我们在属灵的身量上能长大,
and our spiritual stature will also grow.
所以亲爱的弟兄姊妹,
Dear brothers and sisters,
这个恩膏的教训啊, 要在凡事上教导你们,
this anointing will teach us in everything.
大事, 小事,
large matters or small matters.
我们以为小事, 不需要圣灵来教导,
we thought that small things, we don't need the anointing to teach.
大事就求求神了,
and when great things come, then we will pray to God.
但是神爱我们是无微不至的,
but God loves us is to the uttermost.
小事他也要管, 大事他也要教导,
he will be involved with small things and large things.
你嫌他太麻烦吗?
You think he is too troublesome?
他要你完全像他完全一样,
because he wants you to be perfect as he is perfect.
感谢赞美神,
we thank and praise God.
这样的爱, 你在哪里看得见呢?
Where can you see such love?
他爱我们到这样的地步,
he loves us to this stage.
如果我们顺从恩膏的教训, 就常住在基督里,
if we obey the teaching of the anointing, and we will always abide in him.
我们是不是盼望能常住在基督里面呢?
Do we always want to abide in the Lord Jesus Christ?
我们是不是觉得常常从基督里面出来了?
Do we always feel that we are apart from the Lord Jesus?
什么能保守我们常住在基督里呢?
What can keep us abiding in the Lord Jesus all the time?
遵守恩膏的教训,
obey the teaching of the anointing.
因为这是他教训的目的,
and this is the goal, the aim of his teaching.
他不是要增加我们头脑的知识,
he's not trying to increase our head knowledge.
他们要增加基督的身量,
he wants to increase the stature of Christ in us.
亲爱的弟兄姊妹,
Dear brothers and sisters,
神已经都预备好了,
God has already prepared all this.
但是我们,
but we do not exercise.
你不操练, 你就得不着,
if you do not exercise, you will not receive it.
你有这个恩典,
you have this grace,
但是你不去用它,
but you do not use it.
这个恩典就等于没有,
even though you have it, but it's like you don't.
你知道在深海的里面有一种鱼,
you know, yeah,
他有眼睛看不见,
even though in the deep sea there are fish, even though they have eyes but they cannot see.
因为他们在海里从来不用他们的眼睛,
because they dwell in the darkness and they never use their eyes.
因为你不用它就没有了,
because you never use them, you lose them.
连我们的眼睛都要用的嘛,
even our eyes, we need to use them.
有的人能操练他的眼睛到一个地步, 连黑暗中也能看得见,
some people exercise the eyes so that they can even see in darkness.
弟兄姊妹,
brothers and sisters,
神给我们一个知觉,
God gave us this intuition.
他可以在我们知觉里面来教导我们,
he can teach us through the intuition.
但是我们如果不用它,
we do not use it,
我们不操练它,
we do not exercise it,
你越操练, 它就越敏锐,
if you exercise it more, it will become more sharp.
你越不用它, 它渐渐就失去功用,
and if you do not use it, it slowly loses its function.
弟兄姊妹,
Brothers and sisters,
你有没有操练你的直觉？
Brothers and sisters, do you exercise your intuition?
圣经说，
The Bible says,
神是光。
God is light.
在他毫无黑暗。
In him there's no darkness.
这里神是光，不是指着神的话说的。
Here, when it says God is light, it doesn't refer to the words.
神的话是光。
Yes, God's word is light.
因为诗篇告诉我们，他是我们脚前的灯，是我们路上的光。
Because Psalms tells us that his word is the light before our feet.
但是约翰一书第五一章五节里头，神是光，是指着他自己本身说的。
But 1 John 1:5 says God is light. It refers to God himself.
他是光。
He is light.
在他毫无黑暗。
In him there's no darkness.
我们呢？
What about us?
我们都是黑暗。
We are all in darkness.
但是感谢神，光已经照到我们的黑暗里面。
This light has already shined into our darkness.
我记得多年前我在云南。
Many years ago, I was in Yunnan.
有一位弟兄，他去参观一个煤矿。
One brother visited a coal mine.
等到他从煤矿出来的时候，
When he came out from the coal mine,
他看看被人脸上都是黑黑的，他就笑。
He saw everybody that their faces are dark and he laughed at them.
他没有知道他脸上也是黑的。
He didn't realize he himself is also dark.
你知道这是我们人就是这样吗？
This is man.
我们不知道我们的黑暗。
We do not know our darkness.
但是神是光。
But God is light.
在他毫无黑暗。
In him there's no darkness.
你需要他光照你。
You need him to enlighten you.
他这个光是生命的光。
This is the light of life.
这个光是从里面照出来的。
This light comes from the inside.
不是外面照进来。
It's not from the outside.
生命的光在里面发亮。
The light of life enlightens us from inside.
它一发亮，你就知道你黑暗了。
When it enlightens us, you know the light.
所以，在第七节里怎么说？
That's why in verse 7 it says,
我们若行在光中，如同神住在光中，就彼此相交，他儿子耶稣的血也洗净我们一切的罪。
If we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another and the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sins.
我们今天要行走在光中。
We need to walk in light.
这个光是什么光呢？
What is this light?
这是我们里面生命的光。
This is the light of life inside of us.
因为生命就是光。
Because life is light.
生命长大一点，光就多一点。
Life grows, light also grows.
生命小一点，光就少一点。
When the life is smaller, this light is also smaller.
是不是呢？
Isn't it so?
那如果光一来了，你就看见你自己的黑暗了。
When the light comes, you see your darkness.
那你如果行在你所看见的光中，
If you walk in the light that you have seen,
像神是住在光中的，
As God dwells in light,
我常常说神是一百之光啊，你只有一之光啊。
If God is 100 watt, you are only 1 watt,
因为你刚刚得救嘛。
Because you are just saved,
刚刚得救你就有光了。
When you are saved, you have light,
你就知道什么是不对的。
You know what is wrong.
是神所不喜悦的。
You know what's not pleasing to God.
那你如果知道了，你要去遵行啊。
If you know it, you need to obey.
你如果行在光中，
If you walk in light,
像神是住在光里一样，
As God dwells in light,
你与神就有交通，是不是呢？
You have fellowship with God, isn't so?
你良心无愧，
Your conscience is clean.
你能与神有来往，
You have fellowship with God.
那么同时呢？
At the same time,
他儿子耶稣的血也洗净我们一切的罪。
The blood of his son Jesus Christ also cleanses from all our sins.
因为光给我们看见我们从前看不见的黑暗啊。
The light allows us to see what we do not see in the past.
但是感谢神。
But thank God.
我们如果顺服行在光中，主耶稣的宝血就洗净了。
If we obey and we walk in light, the blood of Jesus Christ washes our sins away.
这样我们 就像神更多一点了。
And this way we will be more like God.
那么如果我们一直行在光里头，光越来越大。
If we continuously walk in light, this light will increase.
我们完全顺服我们所有的光。
If we completely obey the light that is in us,
我们与神之间就没有隔膜了。
And there will be no barrier between us and God.
这不是说你完全了。
It doesn't say that you are perfect.
我们不完全。
We will not be perfect.
只有神是完全。
Only God is perfect.
但是他能与我们这不完全的人有交通。
But God can have communion with this imperfect man.
因为我们照着我们所领受的光，我们都行了。
Because we obey and we walk according to the light that we receive.
如果我们不行的话，
But if we do not walk,
我们良心就会责备我。
Our conscience will accuse us.
我们与主的交通就出了毛病。
And our communion with Christ, with God will have a problem.
弟兄姊妹，
brothers and sisters.
所以你看，这是我们基督徒成长的经过。
This is the path of the spiritual growth.
我不知道，到了现在，弟兄姊妹不阿们或者阿们。我所交通的。
I'm not sure if you amen or not amen what I said.
如果你阿们的话，
If you amen what I said,
那么我们要问，
Then we will ask,
我们怎样来操练我们的直觉？
How do we exercise this intuition?
感谢赞美神，我们里面的灵都有直觉的功用。
We praise and thank God that our spirit now has this intuition function.
感谢赞美主。
We praise and thank God.
圣灵像恩膏一样已经住在我们里面。
The Holy Spirit is like an anointment abiding in us.
样样都齐备了。
Everything is well prepared.
你记得加拉太一章十六节怎么说？
Do you remember what Galatians 1:16 says?
神乐意将他儿子启示在我里面。
God is willing to reveal His Son to us.
在神里面没有问题。
In God, there's no problem.
你不要以为说你得不着启示啊，神要负责。
Do not think that if you do not receive revelation, God is responsible for that problem.
神里面没有问题。
No, there's no problem with God.
他乐意。将他的儿子启示在我们里面。
God is willing to reveal His Son in us.
我常常说，当我旅行的时候
，I always say that when I'm traveling.
我如果到一家人家去
，I visit a family.
那一家刚刚生了一个宝贝的孩子
，And if that family just have a child.
我一进门，第一件事情
，When I enter the door, the first thing.
主人。就要把这个孩子抱出来给我看看。
And the host will immediately show me the baby.
你不必问的。
You don't have to ask.
因为他乐意将他的孩子给你看看。
Because he is delighted to show off his child.
这就是我们的神啊。
And this is our God.
他乐意要把他的儿子向我们给我们看看啊。
He is happy to show us his son.
他欣赏他的儿子，他要我们欣赏他。
He values his son just like he wants us to value his son as well.
在神那里没有问题。
There's no problem with God.
问题在我们这里。
The problem is with us.
我们怎样能操练我们的直觉？
How do we exercise our intuition?
我们怎样能得着启示的灵？
How do we receive this spirit of revelation?
我想在这里，我愿意交通两件事。
Let me share a couple of things with you.
第一节
Firstly,
马太福音第五章第八节这样说
Matthew 5:8 says this.
清醒的人有福了，因为他们必得见神。
Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God.
神是无所不在的。
God is everywhere.
但是你看不见他。
But you cannot see him.
为什么
？Why?
因为我们的心不够清。
Because our heart It's not pure enough.
如果我们的心真是完全想着他的,
if our heart is open to him completely,
毫无疑问, 我们要看见他,
there's no problem that we will see him.
主耶稣在地上的时候,
when Jesus was in this earth,
他在加百农、哥拉心一带的地方,
he was in Capernaum and Chorazin.
做了许多的事,
he has done a lot of work.
他们不信他,
but they do not believe him.
所以在马太第十一章里头,
Matthew 11, it says,
主就祷告,
and Jesus prayed,
父啊,
Father,
我感谢你,
I thank thee.
因为你的旨意像婴孩就显明出来,
because you reveal your will to the babies.
像聪明通达的人就隐藏起来,
for to the wise you hide himself, you hide yourself.
你的美意本是如此,
this is your good will.
弟兄姊妹,
brothers and sisters,
神向谁显现?
Who does God reveal himself to?
像聪明通达的人吗?
To the wise and clever people?
不,
no.
像婴孩就显出来了,
but he revealed himself to the babies.
到了马太18章里面,
Matthew 18,
门徒都在那里争什么人最大,
when the disciples were arguing who's the greatest,
主就把一个小孩子带来,
and the Lord brought a child among them.
就说你如果不悔改, 像这小孩子的样子, 不能进天国。
If you do not repent and like a child, you cannot enter the kingdom of heaven.
你如果谦卑像这小孩子, 你在天国里是最大的。
If you humble like a child, you will be the greatest in heaven.
这是一个属灵的秘诀。
This is a secret, a spiritual secret.
你知道中国有一句古话,
you know, there is a Chinese saying,
思故生天机灭。 If you are worldly wise, your heavenly sense destroyed.
Thank you.
我们如果地上的知识太多了,
if we have too much worldly knowledge,
天机就没掉了,
and your heavenly sense will diminish.
小孩子是凭直觉,
children use their intuition.
他们没有很多知识,
they don't have much knowledge.
他们都是开始的时候都是凭着他们里面的直觉,
in the beginning they rely on their intuition.
很稀奇,
very surprisingly,
有的人小孩子看见了就怕,
some children are afraid of some other people.
有的人小孩子看见了就往前去,
and other people, they will just go after them.
他凭什么?
What do they rely on?
凭里面的感觉,
it is from the intuition.
你越大了就越装假了,
the older you are, the more hypocrite you become.
弟兄姊妹是不是?
Isn't it so?
我们都凭着我们的头脑了,
we all walk according to our head knowledge.
想一想,
let's think about it.
分析一下,
let's deduce it.
还是保护自己好,
oh, it's better to protect myself.
弟兄姊妹,
brothers and sisters,
思故生天机灭,
if you know more earthly knowledge, your heavenly sense diminish.
主并没有意思叫我们像小孩子那样的这个 childish.
No, the Lord doesn't want us to be childish.
但是要我们 childlike.
He wants us to be childlike.
Childlike 就说对主有一个清洁的心,
childlike means to have a clean heart towards the Lord.
我什么都不知道,
I know nothing else.
我知道我的父亲,
I know my father.
弟兄姊妹,
brothers and sisters,
如果我们的心是向着他清洁的,
if our heart is pure towards him,
他一定会多多在我们的知觉里面教导我们,
he will teach us in our intuition.
这是一点,
this is one thing.
或者我先用一个比喻吧,
Let me use another parable or example.
这是个真的事情。
It's a real thing.
我不知道弟兄姊妹你们有没有念过 My Utmost for His Highest?
I don't know if you have read the book called My Utmost for His Highest.
竭诚为主。
My Utmost for His Highest.
这是 Oswald Chambers 写的。
Written by Oswald Chambers.
Oswald Chambers 是活在二十世纪末叶的时候，二十世纪对，二十世纪这个的时候。
This brother Chambers lived in the latter part of the 20th century.
他这个人又是一个美术家，又是一个哲学家、心理学家，这个。很聪明的一个人。
He's very wise. He's an artist. He's a psychologist, also a philosopher.
他信了主之后
，After he believed in Jesus,
他也会讲。
He's very eloquent.
他是英国人。
He's a British person.
但是他有差不多六年的时间。
For about 6 years.
在外表上，他好像是一个很前进的基督徒。
On the outside, he seems to be a very godly Christian.
但是他里面觉得黑暗。
But inside him, he felt darkness.
所以他在神面前去寻求。
Then he prayed before God.
他觉得说他需要被圣灵充满。
He felt that he needed to be filled by the Holy Spirit.
但是怎么都得不着。
But even though he tried, but he didn't get it.
等到有一天。
Until one day.
当他在读路加福音十一章十三节的时候
，Until one day he was reading Luke 11:13.
你们虽然不好，尚且知道把好东西给你们的儿女，何况你们天上的父，岂不更将圣灵赐给求他的人吗
？Even though you are evil.But you are still give the good things to your children. Even so, the Heavenly Father, would he not give the Holy Spirit to those who ask of him?
他里面豁然开了。
And inside him, he suddenly become brightened up.
他就用简单的信心接受主的话。
With a simple faith, he accepted the word of God.
他没有什么特别的感觉。
He didn't have any special experience.
但是他用一个像小孩一样的信心来接受主的话语。
He has a faith of a child to accept the word of God.
从那个时候去
，From that time on,
他生命有个极大的转机。
His life was completely changed.
他在一切的事情上，他都能用婴孩的态度。信靠神。
From that day on, in everything, he can use a child, the faith of a child to trust God.
没有什么难处能叫他觉得为难。
There's no difficulty too great for him.
他完全简简单单的相信神。
He just believed God like a child.
结果就在我们这一个时代被神大大的使用。
As a result, he was greatly used by God in our age.
就是表明说
So what does it say?
如果我们在神面前有一个像小孩一样的清洁单纯的心
If we have a faith pure like a child,
神就要把他的心意多多的告诉我们
And God will reveal his will to us.
很多时候我们得不着因为我们太聪明太懂了。
Oftentimes we did not receive it's because we are too wise, we think we know too much.
如果你念过这个正常的基督徒生活
If you have read the book called Normal Christian Life,
你知道我们亲爱的弟兄尼特森弟兄他有这样的见证。
You know, Brother Watchman Lee has this testimony.
他已经信主好多年了。
He has believed in the Lord many years already.
他已经在那里侍奉神了。
And he has been serving God already.
但是当他在追求的时候,
when he was pursuing the Lord,
当然他看了很多属灵的书。
Yes, he did read a lot of books.
他看见这个解经的人解说罗马第六章。
He has read a lot of expositions of Romans chapter 6.
说我们的旧人已经与基督同钉十字架，叫我们罪生灭绝，不再做罪的奴仆。
That our old man has been crucified with Christ, and that our evil body will not be our master, that we do not dwell in sin anymore.
那怎样能经历与基督同时呢？
But how do we experience dying with Christ?
他在十字架上已经把我们旧人致死了。
On the cross, he already crucified our old man.
那我们今天怎么能来经历这个呢？
Today, how do we experience that?
那么很多人告诉他说， 你要根据罗马六章第十一节。
So many people told him that, look, you have to follow Romans 6.
你要 reckon, 你要算你自己像罪在基督里是死的，像神在基督里是活的，那就行了。
You have to reckon that you have died in Jesus Christ and living, died to sin and lived to Christ.
所以他就算。
And so he reckon.
越算越活。
The more he reckon, the more he become alive.
越算他的旧人越活。
The more he reckoned, the more his old man is alive.
不肯死,
not willing to die.
那真是没有办法。
So he is powerless.
等到有一天,
until one day,
他在早晨读经的时候,
in the morning when he was reading the Bible,
忽然主开他的灵窍,
and God opened up his sense.
神给他看见,
God allows him to see.
为什么我们 已经与基督同钉十字架。
Why are we crucified with Christ already?
因为我们在基督里。
Because we are in Christ.
如果基督钉十字架,
if Christ was crucified,
我们在他里面,
we are in him,
那我们也钉死咯。
We are also crucified with him.
哎呀, 这个光一来啊, 他真是感谢主。
When this light shined into him, he was really praying and praising God.
他跑下楼来,
so he came down from the stairs.
看见一个弟兄,
he saw a brother.
他就抓住他,
and he grabbed hold of him.
他说, 弟兄,你知道我已经死了吗?
Brother, you know that I'm dead already.
那个弟兄说什么?
The brother said, what were you talking about?
弟兄姊妹,
brother, sisters,
这是启示。
This is real.
这是启示的灵。
This is revelation.
这个灵,启示灵一来有功效。
The spirit of revelation comes, it has a result.
头脑的知识有知道,行不出来。
The head knowledge, you know, but you cannot apply it.
启示叫我们实行出来。
Revelation allows us to apply it.
我能举许多的例子。
I can tell you a lot of examples.
但是没有时间了。
But we are running out of time.
第二点。
Secondly,
如果我们要操练知觉,
if we need to exercise our intuition,
我们要学习顺服,
we need to exercise obedience.
因为你顺服已经有的光, 神就把更多的光给你。
If you obey the light that you have already received, and God will give you more light.
如果你不顺服他已经给你的光,
if you do not obey the light that God has already given you,
神就不会把其他的光给你。
God will not give you more light.
因为神是非常讲实际功用的。
God talks about practicality.
我做一个小的见证。
Let me give you a real testimony.
我信主之后非常热心。
After I believed in Christ, I was very fervent.
糊涂热心,
and it's a foolishly fervent.
到处传福音,
And I preached the gospel everywhere.
跑到乡下去传福音。
I went to the villages.
人已经死了，最后
man already died.
放手在他身上，叫他复活。
And I lay hand on this dead person.
而那个人是 meningitis 死的。
They died of meningitis.
脑膜炎呢？
meningitis.
那是传染的了。
It's infectious.
那个时候什么都不懂。
At the time, I don't know nothing.
以为自己是服侍神。
Thinking that I am a servant of God.
我小的时候。
When I was young.
就已经受了滴水礼了。
I was sprinkled.
因为我父亲是牧师。
Because my father was a pastor.
但是等我得救之后
，After I was saved，
有人告诉我说
，And some people told me，
你这个滴水不行的
，This sprinkling of water is no good。
圣经里头的受洗啊是受浸
，In the Bible baptism is to be baptized inside into the water。
我很反对
，I was really against it。
并且我很有理由
，And I was not full of reasons。
我说我婴孩的时候啊，受这个滴水啊。
When I was even a baby, I was really already sprinkled.
是奉父子圣灵的名啊。
And I was sprinkled in the names of the Father, the Spirit, and the Son.
我不能亵渎神的名啊。
I cannot despise the name of God.
所以我不能推翻这个事情。
I cannot refute this.
所以什么人来对我讲，我就与他辩论。
And anyone that come to argue with me, I will argue back.
但是当我在读圣经的时候。
But when I was reading the Bible,
慢慢就觉得说，圣经，信道受浸啊。
Yes, the Bible did say about baptism.
我小婴孩的时候，我根本不懂什么叫做信啊。
When I was a child, when I was sprinkled, I didn't even know what does mean by believing.
是我父亲的信啊。
Yes, my father believed.
不是我的信啊。
But not me.
那么圣经说信而受洗吗
？The Bible said, believe and be baptized.
那我这个受洗算不算呢
？So is this sprinkling counted as
baptism? 我说不行。
But my conscience said no.
我已经受过洗了。
In the past, I was sprinkled. I was baptized.
在那一段的时间，我很热心。
At that time, I was very fervent.
但是，什么热心都照着我自己的意思来做。
All this work is according to my how I feel.
等到有一天。
Until one day.
又有人讲我讲受洗的事情。
Someone came and talked to me about baptism again.
我与他争。
And I was debating with him.
争到后来啊，那位弟兄啊，觉得我这个人是太固执了，没有办法，就不理我。
So until a stage that my brother think that I'm too stubborn, and he will just ignore me.
我就坐在那里，默默地祷告。
So I was sitting there praying.
我说主啊
，Lord，
我知道有一天我要受浸呢。
I know one day I will be baptized.
但是现在不方便。
But now it's not convenient.
因为我还做学生呢。
I'm still a student.
我父亲是牧师啊。
My father is a pastor.
我爱我的父亲啊。
I love my father.
我不能违背他。
I cannot disobey him.
来受浸啊。
That to be baptized.
这个我对不起他的。
I cannot do this against him.
所以我说神啊。
So I said, God.
我答应你。
Let me promise you.
我大学毕业之后。
When I graduate from
university. 我自己独立了。
And I will be independent.
我就要受浸了。
Then I will be baptized.
很有理由啊。
That's very reasonable.
忽然一个声音来。
And then suddenly there's a voice in me.
这是我第一次好像听见一个声音。
This is the first time as if I hear a voice.
爱父母胜过爱我的，不配做我的门徒。
Love your parents more than me. It's not worthy to be my disciple.
这句话摸着了。
This word touches me.
我说主啊,
so I said, Lord,
我要做你的门徒,
I want to be your disciple.
刚好我的朋友住的地方就在你弟兄住的隔壁。
My friend lived just next door to Brother Lee.
他在那里睡觉，作为弟兄。
He was just sleeping there.
我就从楼下下去。
So I came down from upstairs.
打隔壁的门。
So I knocked at the door next door.
你弟兄从楼上下来。
So Brother Lee came down from the second floor of his house.
他说你要做什么？
So he said, what do you want?
我说我要受浸。
I said, I want to be baptized.
他说你父亲知道不知道？
So he said, does your father know?
我说他不知道。
He doesn't.
但是,
but
我觉得主要我做。
I felt that God wants me to do it.
我第二天就受浸了。
The next day, I was baptized.
我为什么讲这段事情呢？
Why do I mention this event?
因为我那一次的顺服开了我的窍。
Because that obedience opened up my 我的窍是什么？ My
我过去也读圣经。
In the past, I read the Bible, yes.
也祷告。
I also pray to God.
但是里面的窍不通。
But in the inside of me is not open up.
我完全用我自己的头脑去领会。
I only read the Bible with my head.
为什么？
Why?
因为我里面有不顺服。
Because inside of me, there is this disobedience.
我没有行在光中。
I was not walking in light.
我如果不行在光中,
if I do not walk in light,
我就在黑暗里头。
I am in darkness.
但是感谢赞美主。
I thank and praise God.
当我那一次顺服的时候,
that day when I obey,
我里面的心窍开了。
My heart was open.
从那个时候起, 光一步一步的照亮。
From that day on, the light increases in me.
我不是说我绝对顺服。
I'm not saying that I obey completely.
我与神在那里摔跤，也不晓得什么摔了多久了。
I fought with God many times.
我像雅各一样。
Just like Jacob.
但是感谢神。
But thank God.
他没有放弃。
He never let go of me.
所以我学了一个功课。
I learned this lesson.
我们要得着启示。
If we want revelation,
我们要操练直觉。
We need to exercise intuition.
第一, 我们的心要向神。
Firstly, our heart shall be pure like God.
第二,
secondly,
他给我们光的时候, 我们要顺服。
When he gives us light, we must obey.
这样的话, 我们里面直觉就会越多越得着光。
And our intuition will receive more and more light.
叫我们在圣洁上有份。
And we will be, we have a part in his holiness.
我觉得说, 良心是与公义发生关系。
I always felt that conscience is related to righteousness.
直觉是与圣洁发生关系。
Intuition is related to holiness.
因为良心告诉我们是非。
Our conscience tells us what is right and wrong.
神所认为的是和神所认为的非。
What God considers right and what God considers wrong.
直觉是告诉我们什么是神的旨意，什么不是神的心意。
Our intuition allows us to discern what is the will of God and what is not.
所以这个与我们的圣洁发生关系。
And this relates to our holiness.
不单是如此。
Not only that.
并且直觉带进四分。
带进什么？
直觉。
Oh. Intuition brings along surface.
在直觉的里面, 神会引导我们怎样来服侍他。
In intuition, God allows us to know how to serve him.
因为 我们侍奉神不是照着我们所看为美的。
When we serve God, is it not according to what we think is good?
我们侍奉神必须要根据他的旨意。
When we serve God, we need to serve according to His will.
所以，亲爱的弟兄姊妹
，Dear brothers and sisters,
巴不得神恩待我们。
May God have mercy on us.
叫我们在圣灵指导的底下来操练我们的直觉。
Under the teaching of the Holy Spirit, we will exercise our intuition.
我们祷告。
Let's pray.
主啊，我们把我们的心向你打开。
Lord, we open up our hearts to you.
求你的光照亮。
Please enlighten us.
越照越明。
Enlighten us brighter and brighter.
直到正午。
Until the noon sun.
把荣耀归给你。
May glory be to you.
奉主的名。
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.